What a sweet kid.
I bet she's a rolling model for Coco.
And so, let's finally start this video by saying what this video isn't. First, this video isn't discussing the everlasting problems of GNOME software. Second, this video isn't discussing how important a good app store is for the desktop. And third, it isn't either discussing how important is for the large GNOME desktop vendors, like Fedora and Ubuntu, Endless and all the rest, to have the same storefront, which is obviously the biggest concern with Souk. Instead, this is only a quick demo on Souk for Master, and even if it is far from ready, it is one pretty good app. But most importantly, it was designed correctly from the very start. So come with me, and see! First of all, when I said Souk has a proper design, I didn't mean how it looks, but all the rest. Like it is written on GTK4 from the start, and of course it is also written on Rust, which is the unofficially official framework of GNOME apps, and don't even dare to start a GNOME app to any other language. Eventually you're gonna regret it. And like all this happiness wasn't enough, Souk is already mobile friendly with some early libHandy Rust bindings from Alexander Mikhailenko. And in general it is safe to start with GTK4 and Rust today. Most of the bindings are here already. The other major design concept of Souk, it's that it is an app store only to manage Flatpaks and nothing else. In fact, Souk it is a Flatpak app itself. On the actual app interface, things are quite on early stages of development. On front page we only have editors picks and recently updated, and there isn't currently a way to browse all the apps from a remote like FlatHub. However there is a search, and it is fast. Seriously fast! Typing for text, and boom! Everything is displayed instantly. Search for video, and boom again. Although I'm pretty sure it is missing results, but I'm not sure why. Meanwhile we have some labels, like on beta releases, or this icon for an already installed app. By the way, Souk is written by Felix Hacker, also the creator of Shortwave app. So inside the app details page we have some application screens. Then we have the app description, and what's new. Next we have some links like donations and issues reporting, and finally we have a section with more apps from the same creator similar to Elementary App Center. Although what's the important thing here is a similar app. Also, app installation already works, although the feedback UI isn't something spectacular. And after the installation is completed, we can just launch the app, or remove it. In general I don't want to discuss the UI too much, because everything will be completely different in a few weeks. Actually I'm seeing new commits while recording this video. But anyway, so we also have a view with our installed apps, and again the thing I like the most here is the labels. Like beta and master. And finally we have a view with our updates, but it doesn't seem to work. Basically I didn't check the code either to really know. Another thing I don't know either is how Souk is updating the app data. But there is this item on menu that we can force a refresh on demand. Oh, and that's Souk's official icon, if you were curious about that. Super irrelevant, but do you see this radius on bottom corners? That's a GTK4 theme change, but I believe they reverted it on some recent patches. Well, that was pretty much everything for now. And I totally believe that's going to be the next most significant GNOME app, because it is GTK4 already. It is written on Rust. The developer is good. The app itself is useful. And GNOME software is doomed to fail with all those it is trying to achieve, plus it is on C. Speaking of software, I want to read you something from Souk's README, that was added 2 hours ago. So, is Souk trying to replace GNOME software? The answer is no. GNOME software does a lot more things, like doing firmware upgrades, managing package git packages, or doing complete OS upgrades. We don't want to add such functionality in Souk. Then again, if Souk isn't going to replace GNOME software, what is trying to do? To give us two app stores? But for me at least, Souk has already replaced it. I range removed GNOME software yesterday, after watching it eating my RAM alive without doing anything. And to come to a video end, the best way to try Souk is to clone it on Builder, and then hit the play button. It will take around 7 minutes for build to complete, and after you can also export a Flatpak bundle and install it to your system. So we are finally done. Coco out.